One of the first things we're going to do in setting your shop up to do online inspections is add your employees. Simply go into settings. We're going to start with a manager. And as true in any part of the program where you see the little plus sign, you can always add something. So we're going to add a manager to our list currently. We're going to put Tom in. And we're going to generate a quick password for Tom. Just pass 123. Put his name in. And we're all set. I don't need to fill out the other information. If you'd like to, you can. The reason I generated a temporary password is the system is going to send Tom an email immediately announcing his acceptance into the program and also giving him the option to log in and change his password. So that's why we just generate a quick password. The passwords do have to be a combination of letters and numbers. Hit save, and you can see that Tom Smith is now in the system. He can go ahead and log in and start working with it. If we choose to turn Tom off, we've always got the inactive button here that we can click on, and now he won't be able to log into the system. Same system holds true for adding mechanics. We're going to go down here to the mechanic section. We're going to add a new mechanic, and this is going to be Mike. And again, generated a quick temporary password, just pass 123. And we have a couple of options down here with the mechanic. We can allow Mike to add inspections, or we can turn that off and he won't be able to add inspections. My shop, I prefer to let the technicians go ahead and add them just in case the service advisor isn't up to speed and hasn't generated one yet. The other option here is allowing the mechanic to view all of the inspections or just the ones that is assigned to them at their login. I prefer to let all of my mechanics see all of the inspections just in case one guy is helping out another or whatever. Hit save, and you can see here that Mike Smith is now in the system, ready to go. If at any time we need to make changes, we can click on the edit button and change these defaults if we need to. That's it for adding employees. Go through your list, add